So hello everyone and welcome to the class for transportation engineering. I am Professor Kakade Vedi and we are learning unit number 3, which is traffic engineering and control devices. Okay, so in that particular unit we have deal with many topics and in that we have came across the series of studies or series of traffic surveys, where we have learned two traffic surveys, which is first one is a traffic volume study and second one is the origin and destination study. So now we are moving towards a next traffic study, which is speed study, or in that topic there is a subtopic like spot speed study. So without wasting time, let's get started and check out the video. Okay, so here in the last lecture there was origin and destination study, and origin and destination study was represented by the desire line diagram. Okay, so what is the desire line diagram? It is the diagram which is showing the number of trips between two stations. Okay, so more the thickness of a desire lines, so that trips are represented by desire line. So more the width of the desire line, more will be the trips of the, or more will be the importance of the particular area, that two stations. Okay, so in that the next study of our traffic survey is speed study. Okay, so in the speed study it is important to know the distribution of performance, okay, of the traffic on existing road of urban planning system. So we are collecting data of a existing road system. Okay, so where we have collect the data regarding the speed of the vehicle. Okay, speed of the vehicle. So what is the speed of a vehicle? What should be the speed of vehicle? Is there is a reason to provide any kind of what we can say, remedy for that, or control devices for this? It is important to be learned, so that's why we require the data and we just conduct this speed study. Okay, speed data is needed for variety of a traffic analysis. Okay, so if we are going to provide a major road across the city from an existing road, so in that we must know that what is the variety of traffic and what is the different speed of a vehicle which is achieved on the particular area. Okay, so these are the major objectives of a speed study. First one is a traffic control and planning for the speed limit, which is maximum and minimum. Traffic control planning and speed limit with respect to the speed zoning analysis, school zone protection, regulatory warning and guide sign, length and passing zone, etc. If the road, so here which we will consider one thing is that related to the zones. Okay, to consider the zone or to divide that particular area with respect to the zone, we must understand what is the exact speed of a vehicle which is achieved at the particular area. Okay, if there is a school zone at there, okay, if there is a school at the, so density or the, we can say the crowd at the particular area is more, so the restriction for the traffic speed must be provided. But first we must understand what is the average speed at which the area, or we could say that the particular vehicle which is passing through the area are at the time. Okay, so what is the average speed for the area, we calculate, and on the basis of that we provide a zoning system and restriction. Okay, and also for passing zone, if there is a road crossing at particular situation, to cross the road there must be a signaling system to be provided. If the road is not that much of a crowded, we avoid to provide a signaling system or control system, and in that area we could provide some systems which restrict the speed. Okay, speed trend, high speed zone. Okay, if the area is of the particular road is very high speed zone, then we will avoid to provide crossing, and we will provide overbridge or underbridge, or overpassing bridge or underpassing bridge, to avoid the collision. Okay, so if there is a high speed area, and if this is a low speed area, we will provide, and to achieve the average speed, we will provide sufficient smooth and non-intersecting road. Okay, non-intersecting road for the particular situation. Then next is the maintain traffic speed with respect to planning, geometric design, and different characteristics. So here, for maintain the traffic speed in planning and geometric design, and features, location, driver characteristics, okay, traffic condition, climatic condition, that kind of the situation we must to be understand. If we could consider that the particular zone is a high speed zone, and we are providing geometric which is very poor as compared to the other road, in that situation we could alter the geometric design. Then planning, in the sense of the signaling system or traffic controlling system, with respect to the speed we have to provide it. Then next condition is the different characteristics. Here the different characteristics come with the characteristics of a vehicle. Okay, vehicular characteristics, road characteristics, road user characteristics, that kind of the characteristics are considered, and we must to study the what is the speed. Okay, if the road characteristics are very poor and the speed is very high for the particular, so we must to reduce the speed to avoid the accident. And next is the accident analysis. What is the major reason of an accident which we calculated or analyzed in the accident study? So when accident study is analyzed, we must to understand what was the actual speed of the or average speed of the vehicle at that particular point. If the speed is high and the particular vehicle which is met with the accident is having a very low speed, then we have to let the people to understand they should achieve the average speed. Okay, then capacity study. Okay, so what is the capacity, actual capacity of the particular road is must to be understand. For vehicle spacing, here is the point that we understand one thing, is that the vehicle spacing should be achieved with respect between the two vehicle, the spacing between two vehicle is must be achieved with respect to the speed. Okay, if there is all the vehicles are running with the average speed or normal speed, then there must be a proper spacing between that vehicle to avoid the collision or to maintain the stopping side distance. Okay, so that there must be find out what is the average speed of the particular vehicle or traffic. Okay, so the vehicle spacing is maintained on the basis of that speed of the vehicle or traffic, and that must be understand or calculate. Then signboard visibility, if there are too many signboards or signboard which is important like compulsory signboard, warning signboards, if there are placed on the beside the road and the vehicle are of a very high speed vehicle are running from it, they are not able to visible or able to read that board. Okay, so that's why we have to calculate or find out what is the average speed of the vehicle, and on the basis of that we must to provide the signboard here. Okay, so that these are the major objectives to conduct the speed study of a vehicle. In the start of the this chapter we have discussed that the different studies we must to conduct for collecting the different data. After collecting the different data, we will be able to analyze the different and provide the solution. So speed study is one of this that particular survey. Okay, next is the type of speed. Okay, next is the type of speed. Next point is type of speed. What is the different type of speed of a vehicle which we collect or require during its traffic journey, during its traveling journey? Okay, and which speed we required to be understand. Okay, here first one is the running speed. Running speed is the mean speed which can be maintained over the given route at the time, okay, of a motion of vehicle is called as running speed. In the sense, it is just total speed from which what is the average speed or mean speed which during its whole journey or motion. Okay, next is the operating speed. Okay, so here according to existing feature of a traffic and environment condition, the speed of a driver speed of a vehicle driver maintain is known as an operating speed. Okay, on the basis of what is the surrounding condition and what is the environmental condition. If there is a fog around the road or there is a heavy rain, it means that the operating speed obviously will be low. Okay, and the driver should maintain the speed low for the safety reason. If someone is raising the speed at that condition, it means that it is providing a threat for the itself and the other vehicle also. Next is the spot speed, where the spot speed study is considered that a sudden speed of a vehicle on the particular spot or on the particular point is known as spot speed. Okay, on the particular point it is known as spot speed. Next is the journey speed. Okay, so it is the obviously journey speed means it is the total speed at the particular time span between its traveling. Okay, the overall speed with which a vehicle travel within the given route between two terminal is known as an journey speed. Okay, last one is the cruising speed. Okay, atmospheric condition are the only speed controlling factor. The running speed of the unimpaired vehicle is called as cruising speed. Okay, when if there is a atmospheric condition affect on the speed of a vehicle, it known as cruising speed. Okay, these are the different speed which are generally vehicle with respect to the vehicle are calculated. So one is important is a spot speed. So spot speed is the important with respect to it. We just calculate or we just conduct one study with respect to that. Okay. So next is the spot speed study and what is the methods of spot speed study and how the what is the procedure of conducting spot speed study, its application, all are conducted or we will learn in the next lecture. Until then, please watch our video and subscribe our channel.